Here's your Storm Tracker weather forecast with Chief Forecaster Bob McGuire.
You know, one of the nice things about living out on the plains is that you have some of the most spectacular sunrises and sunsets. Here's a picture from Sandy Dara. This was this morning sunrise out there by Glendive. And as you see, it was a gorgeous one. Take a look at this one here. This is from Jeff Bilhars. And this is out by Colstrip. This was just north of Colstrip. This morning sunrise, cool looking shot there as well. Now, here's the way it looks at Billings right now. This is 4th Avenue. And this was interesting tonight. We had a lot of icy conditions on 4th Avenue. And I was able to take a ride here going all the way towards the Heights tonight. It took me about 20 minutes to go from here all the way to Exhibition Drive. Just four lanes of cars, icy roads, and everybody moving at about maybe 2 miles per hour. That's what we had. Now, currently, it's pretty chilly, 18 degrees. We still have a little light snow fog in the area, and east wind at about 6 miles per hour. Now, our reported high today actually was 27, so even that was kind of a chilly day. 50 degrees is your normal high. The record 77 back in 1999. Record low was zero back in 1936. And as far as precipitation, well, out of all that snow, you melt it all down. We came up with 0.05 of an inch of rain today, or I should say precipitation today. And so it takes us to 2700s for the month. I only need to be a 1500s on the year. We're at 1813. I only need to be a 1268. So as we move on, you can see our current temperatures around the state. Look at how cold it is up here at Cutbank. 3 degrees right now, 6 over at Great Falls. Teens here in the rest of eastern Montana, 12 over a mile city here in Billings. We're at 18. It's a little warmer out in the west into the 20s and 30s out there. And as you'll see here, our reported highs today, we got up to 40 degrees over at Dillon. That was a hot spot in the state. But back here in the east, it was mostly 20s for afternoon highs, 41 at Warland in Wyoming. And as we move on here, see, here's the story. A little light snow showers moving in the Billings area. This is just about moving out. I think this thing is just about done with us. Elsewhere, a new batch of snow out here by Kalispell and Missoula. I think that'll follow the spine of the Rockies and not come out onto the plains for us. So here's what we see at the moment. We still have a little bit of the jet stream is arching a little bit, but I think it's going to start taking most of that snow instead of slipping it into Billings. It'll probably move a little bit farther south into Wyoming tonight. And so at the surface, high pressure pushing in, this little stationary front will just fall apart. And you'll see we're looking at some scattered snow showers, seeing that just pushes out of the area. Then by Thursday, mostly sunny skies moving in, but it's going to be still on the cool side because we do have some cold air dropping down from Canada. High pressure building in behind that. Then here comes a warm front, moisture kind of rolling over the top of this high pressure cell, and that'll bring us some scattered snow showers again for northwestern Montana, north central Montana. Even some of that by Friday night could make its way into the Billings area. How much snow are we talking about? Well, we're not talking a lot. Here in Billings by Saturday, 6 a.m., it'll be about 0.3 of an inch. Great Falls could pick up maybe another couple inches of snow, but look at this. Later on by Wednesday of next week, now we're talking over 5 inches for Great Falls. Billings could pick up maybe 1.5 inches by the time the middle part of next week gets here. In the meantime, tonight our temps cool back down to the teens across most of the region, 8 degrees over at Red Lodge. Then tomorrow back to the 30s, maybe 40 degrees at Hardin with mostly sunny skies, still a little chilly. Tonight in Billings, 15, 40% chance for snow overnight and mostly cloudy. Next 7 days looks, well, they're gone. Well, I can't tell you the next 7 days. We're going to be looking at temperatures continuing to stay into the 30s for a while. And then by the time next week gets here, we get back up into the 40s. Let's go back to the desk.